summer.
Borderline paralyzed here.
I knew that this house was going to be haunted, but I was not expecting the turnout that we had. I'm probably going to have bad dreams tonight.
Track's dirty. I also wanted to add a scenery update real quick. So you've already noticed this, so I don't need to show any more of that, but that's a grain loading thing, or sand or whatever you want to call it. But that loads on the grain cars, obviously, and that could be transported over to that silo over there, which has been there for the longest time, really. So that's cool. So we finally did some scenery on this corner right here. We got this little barn shop slash thing, this little truck up front. We did some grass, a little road leading out to it. Then we have the yard master building. There's some cars parked outside. Nice little sports car, a little farm truck, and then a railroad company truck. Then we have this electric box for the switches down here. We also got some holders for the controllers, so that's also good. And yeah, so it's yard master right there. We got the J class going. It's good. So there's a lot of scenery stuff around because we've been trying to finish up the scenery real quick. I mean, there's a lot of scenery that needs to be done in here too, because it's all black right now. And we also did these two corners back here. So back there we have a cattle pen, farmhouse, and a hay storage area. We haven't put the hay in there yet. That's what that little red building is. We got a farm truck, we got a cattle truck as well. My dad loves trucks, so. Pathway going right here, some gravel that leads onto the road, and then we got a house right here, a barn-ish house, a very old house. Truck out front, then another electric box for the switches down here, I think. Yes, right here. And then over here we have an electric box for the these two switches over here, and then electric box for, I think, what should be a railroad crossing. I don't know if we're gonna put one in, but by this box right here, I bet it's foreshadowing that we might put one in. I don't know yet. That's just a little scenery update I wanted to do, and I hope you enjoy the little clip of that. I really need to clean that track, sorry.
I'm done doing that. I'm come back, put that track pack thing together, and run that down to the deal. I'm just gonna. Most all the train stuff I get now, I put it together. That store down there, kind of, yeah, but now it's packed. I did go to the railroad museum this morning.
Yeah, you did?
I talked to James down there about, I walked in there and told him about the booth. You know that guy everybody's talking about? I said, go down there. Go see on the face stuff, see Anderson down there. I said, if I know that's what you're looking for, I said, then that's what I'll pick up.
to the fire. You gotta tell us when you're getting ready to kill it. So you're getting all right. I look on your face. It's Colin, right there, in the second one.
The story of the brothers Gibb is a roller coaster ride of triumph and tragedy. I feel like every time that we want to just bolt or leave, we forget something or we abandon some piece of gear. And this kind of stuff is helpful.
You shouldn't be smoking around the boys.
When we came back inside, Omar was like,
"We had engines that have needed maintenance, but it's typically your normal stuff. Traction tire blowouts. I did have a board fry and a third rail engine once. Funny story about that. If you've ever seen the video on my channel that says the most fragile engine on my layout, it's about my brass Yellowstone. I got that engine used, and I don't buy a lot of trains used, but that was one of the first ones I did, and it showed up, and I put on the track, and the board was just dead. So I called Sid, because Sid doesn't live too far from me. It's about an hour or so away, and he ended up coming to my house that night at like 10 o'clock at night, repaired the board, got the engine running, and I made the video. So if you've ever seen that video, I literally did that in like a night. It's just kind of funny that he was able to do that. So if you know someone who can fix, great. Andy Gaby, RDP Trains, are you planning to get any Austin trains? I don't know if they make any of that at O-Gage. If you find something like that, feel free to drop me a comment or hit me up on Instagram about that. That would be great. Welcome if you're just joining the stream. This is my first time live streaming, so...
You have that brush
over there.
Can you get it?
Hold on.
It's way too fast.